Intro pa lang. Watashi wa hijoni nagai aida musicianship wo onjuku shite kimashita ga, Filipino wa musicalの seikatsu ga nai という事実を結論つけることがあんまりにも頻繁にあんまります。Filipino wa musicalの seikatsu ga nai という事実を結論つけることがあまりにも頻繁にあります。これはロクとトイレの土地です。いくつかの鍵と音符が常に結力して音楽がなぜそう聞こえるかについての科学的な something like that. This is a document or one of the writings I used to learn some of the words I like from Nihongo. And wala lang, just to record it a bit because I haven't been recording Nihongo in a while. So I kind of want to hear how that sounds in this podcast.Also, welcome to the show, guys. My name is Rez. I go by other names also, but you can call me just Farmer Rez for the purpose and the benefit of this kind of content. I'll hit you up now with an intro called Summarize, as in summary. Our song I wrote in the heat of the pandemic. And now it's the new OP song of our podcast.
Anak ng tupa patingin.Huwag mo nang itago ang alam mong sa akin Pinabili ko yan At saka pinahiram Solo na agad Wala pang araw banda niyaBilisan mo pa natatabingi na naman ang oras ko Tanginang may COVID pang nalalaman Anak ng tupa patingin Babaguin ko ang pagtingin mo sa akin Comment ka namanBago ka makialam Bilisan mo pa baka mawili na naman ang nanay ko Pagbigyan ka ng bato At saka mo pa nako Siyang bingla mong masilayan Ang totoo Wala na tayong pera bro Huwag mo nang isipin pang malalim tayo
はい、どうぞ。これは日本人クラックソロポッドキャストです。これに加えて FCI マンタネのルイジ様のブランドです。
はい、どうぞ。これは日本人クラックソロポッドキャストです。これに加えて NCI マンタネのルイジ様のブランドです。
Alright, salamat sa pakikinig. This is a 20-minute show. Intro, usually. Please do like and share if you're a regular na or something or you kind of want to medyo magpakilala ng sundot. and that's kind of like the deal here. Recently, masaya ako, you know. There are around, I think, in my estimates, there are about around 60.Regular, listeners and... Hindi ko alam kung listeners o naiki-usisa lang, naiki-tingin lang. I mean, not every day that you can see, a wandering Jew. And so this, yeah, the whole's barred, you know. This video, I think I'll focus now on... pahapyaw na review nung kabilang video para sa mga...OC, and then yung gustong discuss na character sa fictional book ko, and also one of my favorite characters in history, and also my pseudonym. So I'm gonna title this, and I hope I could explain more, and or may enough na oras. I'm gonna title this Late Bloomer. Okay, so it's a video about the character Bradley Chong and my pseudonym Bradley Chong. Okay, yeah. So the intro I was saying, yung basically translation, and if you kind of got confused by that, is ano? Ako po ay isang matagal ng musikero dito sa Pilipinas na nahihirapan ako kasi medyo pangit yung ano, Seikatsuganai to yung Jujutsu Ketsu. Seikatsuganai. Parang pangit yung music world dito, hindi maganda. Kore wa roku to toire no tochi desu. Parang ano dito, puro sex lang, pati ano, pang banyo lang ang ano dito, banyo king. Diba? Ganun yung mga jokes dito. And then towards the end, you know, Ongaku ganaze. So music, maga pa lang, so medyo maingay pa yung mga sa streets. So sana hindi kayo masyado nagugulo. You know, music here is like Chinese, you know, kulang-kulang, diba? Parang yung joke na kumbaga ito sa bar sa likod ko, white keys lang, diba? Walang black keys kumbaga sa piano. Kailangan kumpleto. Kaya lang sa atin kasi puro major keys lang, ayaw mag-minor key. Okay, yun lang inaaral, yun lang yung nagaya. Send nyo na lang dun sa mga banda boys nyo na ano, diba? You know, a lot of the band stuff, really, they don't really tell you, but it is a reflection of your relationship. So if you're in a relationship with a whole bunch of guys, or like whole isa lang yung babae, then that's the result of your music. And culture here is like that, you know, banda, safety in numbers. It's just a criticism that I hold very dearly of what I knew and loved, diba? And I'm sort of also fortunate to have, marami naman, di lang naman ako, diba? Pero I share this, you know, sentiment with electronic music producers, you know, yung mga konti lang talaga na nag-thrive, but still thriving. There are examples like Winiki. There are examples like music producers who are just to have their own studios. I don't know if you guys even know who I'm mentioning, but if you're part of sort of duman na kayo dun sa, you know, my music journey, then you kind of know. But if not, you know, like, I'm here as Farmer Rez. Ang nangyari sa akin, basically, matagal akong hindi bumalik dun sa parang Filipino way of seeing. And, you know, hindi naman ako, wala naman ako talagang, ano, parang big gripe with it. But, you know, ngayon na bumalik na ako sa Filipino way of seeing musicianship, I have to be really honest with how I think about it and be really adamant about how I'm gonna enter that space again. And bukod sa ano, magaling na rin ako mag-English at mag-Tagalog, yun nga, ang explanation nun is my third language now is has entered sort of my lited, which is not surprisingly Nihongo, kasi nga I watch a lot of anime. It's actually kind of big in our Philippine culture as well, bigger than I thought, you know, because it's not minsan niisip ko, dahil ba, ano, may galit ako sa mga Koreano. Wala naman. I actually, you know, enjoy binging Korean stuff. Like, hanggang binge lang. Pero wala akong maintindihan eh. I mean, naiintindihan ko yung aesthetics. Pero mas naiintindihan ko kasi pag Japanese, minsan ini-English audio ko. Pero, you know, the literary effect of Japanese culture in my life has been very, not fetishized, as maybe some of you would argue, beyond fetishized, na parang outlived na, the fleshed out na. So parang, as you can see, you know, I kind of really am also looking for that in my life also. In many things, you know, like even the sadness of it, like I mentioned nga, sorry, may intro lang, warming up. But I mentioned nga na I'm always listening to Japanese broadcast. So, mahilig sa dyan yung mga pinapayak muna sa umaga yung mga tao nila. Pati nakakayak naman talaga yung mga storyahan nila, and then lagi pa sila. Merong mga producers na talagang composition. If you are a Nintendo player, composition talaga yung galawan sa ganyan. Hindi gayahan, hindi paramihan ng gigs, paramihan ng hatak. ano ba yan, diba? Parang bata pa ako ganun ni. Bata pa ako ganun na paramihan ng hatak, bar, sige may bar si ganito, okay. Tapos, diba? Eh, it's a sad reality that we have to deal with. But ako as a musicianship, as a musician, sa musicianship po, diba? I've already, thankfully, you know, I'm really grateful to God about it also to have, anyway, concretely, diba, I'm taking in a new apprentice. So, I think, madalino ka naman, medyo obvious naman yung, in-message nga ako ng mga ex-kabanda ko eh, na gets nila eh, na I'm taking on a new apprentice. And I also mentioned that, late bloomer, right? I also mentioned that one is not able to do such a thing if you haven't also gone through that. And then my nag-comment recently si Pueblo Virtuoso, yun yung ano ko eh, yung guitar master ko nung bata pa talaga ako. Next time ko na lang siya ikikwento. But that's kind of like the Samurai X, you know, pati master niya pangalan nun. Basta parang meron kami mga hidden Mitsurugi kind of galawan minsan. And totoo pala yun. Kala ko naman sa anime lang nangyayari yun. Now, speaking of late bloomers, right? I took in a new apprentice. And she's been part of our family of musicians and artists. And you know, parang belong naman na talaga siya for the longest time. I think even in the way I have been presenting my content or been living my digital life, I'm pretty much sure that some of you guys know her and know of her even. Kasi nga, matagal na eh. Tagal na yung totoong magkaibigan. So now taking her on as a protege. Well, parang the challenge of being the real protege of mine. It's kind of like confusing, but at the same time, it pushes me to have a good discussion with myself and the community behind Someday Dream. So if some of you are curious what the hell I'm leading up to, it's really to sort of hype also and counteract the fact that I've announced that I'm stepping down as main vocalist. So magiging ano na lang ako, sub, sa under na ako, diba? And then, yun nga, it's also beneficial because I am aware that some of the business partners that I have previously made contracts with and since I'm honoring also, you know, technology behind music, which not a lot of people know are parang enabled, that which enables us to live our digital lifestyles na yung kahit na sentimo lang ako kumita, talaga, for the longest time, sentimo lang ako kumita. Cents, by the cents ang bilang ko. Mga, inggit talaga ako, sinasabi ko yun. Inggit ako sa mga construction worker, kung kumita sila, nakakabali sila ng mga tigpa 5,000. Nakakaganon din ako, di ba? Pero iniipon ko pa yung mula sa centavos. Di kagaya iba, piso-piso, di ba? So, hindi naman sa nagpapaawa, pero, I mean, that's me enjoying the capabilities of what we have here. And I'm already a solo musician. Imagine for people or big bands who are like, you know, I don't mean, who sacrificed with big bands, like, and are doubly or even more hardworking or putting more doryogdes, yung effort, diba? May kita niyo yan. And ako, na nag-quit ako, umalis ako, maalis-alis ako, and I'm even not sometimes talking about it. I have dread for music industry stuff. When I come up to my office, alam niyo ba, ganito yung tono ko. Tapos, pag nag-uusap kami na lang naman na lagi, nagsasara kami ng pinto, sinapinapasara yung pinto usually. Kaya na-miss, diba? Kasi, well, wala na ngayon, na-podcast na eh. Naging content na nga eh, if you guys know what I mean. Minsan pag nandun ako sa office, sinasara yung mga pinto kasi ang lakas ng boses ko eh. Tapos syempre ba may mga minsan umaakyat dun si Sir Aris, si kung mga nakasabay ko sa opisina. Anyway, may mga umaakyat dun, marinig nila, ay nandito pala si ano. Parang ganun. So wala na, naging content na lang. Ay ako naman in my head, It's his family. This is family business, guys. This is like, you know how Italians do it, right? And nowadays, you know, speaking of my apprentice, I'm, because of her also, I've been hanging around with, ano, parang mga, hindi naman sa, nag, actually weird nga, kasi I'm hanging around, parang, I feel like now I'm hanging around with Germans and more Japanese type people. Yung pinaka downside nun, irarant ko lang, or, you know, maybe lesson na lang din na, kasi, yung mga, alam mo, I also have a Pinoy side, of course, definitely, even a Chinoy Chinese side, na medyo insecure, ganyan-ganyan, or sanay lang sa Hong Kong way of seeing things. And, it's like, I'm now getting used to yung lamig ng dugo ng ibang ano nationality. Ang lamig ng dugo nila. Pati yung may mga, kumbaga sa may halo, mas na getting used to na ako kaysa before na nagugulat yung soul ko eh. Kasi nga, syempre, hindi man tayo progenitor talaga of these stuff. I'm not sure if it's too vague for you, but yeah, so I'm a late bloomer also. Likewise, I wanna attract also, I have been attracting, you know, who they call as like yung mga losers in the industry daw, or yung mga napag-iwanan na ganyan. Late bloomers, you know. I sometimes, you know, chill out with friends here na I'm honest in my studio now. Hey, I can't take you in, but if you do hang out, my, you know, these guys are here. These guys are, you can watch sort of what we're doing. Ito yung mga tao ko. Ito yung mga kapatid ko. Ito, may mga restaurant kami, blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah talaga yan. May mga sarili-sarili kaming produkto. Bukod dun, we do love music, diba? Hijoni nagayayda musician chi po. O, chuko ko shitekimashita ka. Hindi ko alam yung sabihin lahat nun. Pero matagal na kasi nga ako talagang musician. So, finally, you know, to end this a bit. Ang naging solution ko is to have the base Tagalog theory. Which, around 2015-17, partida, depressed ako nun. I was hanging on to that as like, my parang light at the end of the tunnel, you know, base Tagalog theory. And what does this mean? This is just a string in tech. A string is just like a phrase. Base Tagalog theory, theory of everything, BT.TOE. So, naisip ko lang yun. And then I said, hey, because I have been doing Someday Dream for the longest time, I do have a fictional book. And yung naging logic, yung parang naging, ano niya, parang buo niya is like, if I could have a fictional book, then mas magiging totoo yung Someday Dream for me. Kasi gusto ko siya magkatotoo. Parang hindi nagsulat ako ng fictional book, di ba? So sinabi ko, this is a fictional-based Tagalog story, which is 22 Samay Dela Costa. Some of you guys have already read it, or some of you, it has been leaked. The vibe of it has been leaked. So I'm not surprised. I mean, and then, you know, I sort of embody also my pseudonym for that, because I can't go, you know, full on Rez to Ledo for everything that I do. It's not something that we agree on, as you know, some of us. I can't be Rez to Ledo all the time, because Rez to Ledo is like some sort of matinee idol, diba? Sabi ni Lopez sa akin, matinee idol ka kasi. So parang ako, wala mong masabi, diba? Anyway, yun nga, yun yung Rez to Ledo. And then it's hard to evolve that eh. Now I'm happy na medyo pantay-pantay na yung Rez to Ledo, Heyday Dreamer, and Someday Dream. And that's not being narcissistic. It's because a lot of people knew Heyday Dreamer, and people would actually call me. English lang yung sasabi ko, pero alam nyo naman ito eh. Nag-alakad ako sa dance, sabihin, uy, si Heyday Dreamer, diba? Nakakatawa. Pati ako, mismo, ako natatawa ako sa sarili ko. Hindi nga ako makapaniwala na parang talaga, you guys know me by the title of my song. And eventually, you know, hindi naman sana namimintas, naiintindihan ko na lang siya as like, oh, these guys are the bilingual people. Na bilingual Manila people. Natatawag na lang Heyday Dreamer kasi natuwa sila sa English ko eh. Na nung matagal na panahon, na naturo ka sa kanila yung mga words na dream, fantasy, can finally be, mga ganyan. Yung grammar nun, di ba? Wala silang makitang mali eh. Di tinanggap nila, di ba? If you can't beat them, just join them. Ayun ang nangyari. So, dati hindi naman, ang kinakasaran ko sa career ko dati talaga, ano yung mga asungot, mga ganun. Mga mga jurat, mga ganun, mga taong ganun. Nakaibigan ko din, hindi naman talaga sobrang kasama. Pero so ako kasi yung type ng tao na nagagalit dun sa concept and the timing of things. So medyo technical ako talaga mag-isip. Anyway, so now, I kind of want to reveal that, you know, Bradley Chong, my pseudonym, is actually the Wandering Jew character in 22 Samay Dela Costa. So for late bloomers, the Wandering Jew is actually also called Cartapilus. Siya yung parang high-level guardia na ano sa Jewish tradition na na-encounter si Christ na nakasabit. Na nakasabit na. So, mamamatay na. Tapos nakasabit, tapos may nangyari. Hindi na dinidiscuss ko ano nangyari. Pero kung imaginative ka and you know sort of what I'm referencing to, maybe I'll talk about it, maybe part one na lang to, late bloomers part one. But yeah, Bradley Chong is the who I draw, di ba? Siya yung naka-hat lagi. Kumaga, si Bradley Chong yun. I thought of Bradley Chong because, you know, it's kind of Chinese. And then when I entered also the music scene, Chong yung tawagan eh. Chong. Or like mga tito, di ba tito mo yun, Chong, di ba? Chong, tito mo yun eh. So, yun, di ba? Tapos yung Brad, syempre brother Lee Chong. Eh, at kailangan ko ba sabihin? Ang mga nagtatawag sa akin na Bradley Chong, mga kaibigan kong kalbo, na writer din, director, pati, alam mo yun, mga matatagal ko ng kaibigan, Bradley Chong talaga tawag nila sa akin na. Because they like my writing and I actually am involved in writing they call me sometimes a bard, diba? Parang a bard is like someone who has historically sung the right things. So yun, so ito lang yung reveal ko dito. And Bradley Chong as a wandering Jew, search na lang Cartapilus, is a late bloomer as well, diba? Hindi siya yung tulad natin na matagal ng feeling magaling. Matagal na yung bata pa lang, mayabang na, 'di ba? Si Wandering Jew, hindi siya ganoon. Na-curse siya actually. Kaya naging sa panahon na mas malapit sa panahon natin ngayon, naging siya na si Johnny Walker, naging siya na si Dracula is also Bradley Chong eh. Dracula is also the Wandering Jew. May Wandering Jew na nakasuit, may Wandering Jew na ano, but ang pinaka-quality niya is hindi siya namamatay. Lagi siyang nagtuturo and also meron na siyang parang yung ganun. For my listeners, I'm doing the gesture of holding on to something that it's long. So panoorin nyo lang. Yeah, siya yun. And then Renaissance artists and Renaissance painters have painted the Wandering Jew, Cartapilus, for the longest time. Look at it. Check it out. It's a very interesting Johnny Walker type of thing. And I mean, it reflects in my life, although I don't promote alcoholism, you know, I have friends or I have like people who are involved in that na kasi nga nakikita nila eh, na I do talk about that symbolism. And then now some of my friends actually have been endorsing that kind of lifestyle or just product, you know, pampainit kind of thing. Pero ngayon umaga naman eh, so parang yun, maaga pa. And all the things that I've revealed in this podcast, I guess it's very worth reviewing as well, because for me, a podcast is like, hey, things that I haven't really been talking about or being honest with or even detailing, it's kind of the purpose of that. So I hope this really makes some of you guys, my listeners, the Someday Dream fans, quite happy by the amount of information I've shared. Tapos na ako sa 22-minute mark. Yeah, please do, ano na lang, kung meron pa kayong tanong about the Red Album, I'm not super yung mga press release, ganyan. I do have a podcast, so I'm like, whatever yung dinaldal ko dito is like public property, public information even. So parang if you could clip it, send it to your media, whatever. Not a lot of you are publishers naman eh. And even if you are a publisher, magpapaalam ka pa rin sa akin. Hindi naman sa magpapaalam. Pero of course, if you're a publisher, it's still like, meron pa rin parang ang tawag sa ganun, parang common crediting kind of laws, ganyan. And syempre, kung wala ka namang balak siraan ako or siraan yung brand natin, then it's all good and well. Yeah, so all the information is there actually. It's just that yung strategy ko is yung hindi nyo naririnig yung sound. And I can't, merong embargo on the sound. Parang talagang, yeah. I think that's pretty clear kung paano naman ako gumalaw sa industriya. It's pretty clear na we have made some precautions. And that's also why, ano, diba parang may cautionary effect din yung ano. And, but on top of that, you know, I'm just really enjoying, you know, sa, kumbaga, the inside and the outside, you know, internally and, ano. But, if it would help you guys, konti pa lang talaga yung nakakarinig, of course, production, kakatapos pa lang talaga ng production, we rested it. So parang, they asked me, even my teammates, you know, kailan ba or like anong plano? Sabi ko wala pa, kakatapos pa lang eh. So kind of we're just there also. Okay, I'll just do a part 2 then. Maraming salamat, my name is Rez. And my name is actually not Rez now. But next time ko na explain yung condition na yun. But yeah, please do enjoy the Nyonjin Craft. Meron pa ulit next week. And have a great time always. Bye.
Ang daming nangyayari sa buhay, no?